Good morning, students. It's me, Rajan. Today we are going to discuss remaining part of chapter number first of economics, the story of village Palampur. In our last video, we have discussed organization of production. Now the next topics are farming in Palampur and non-farming activity. Farming in Palampur, first point is land is fixed. Because in Palampur, farming is the main activity. So, some wasteland converted into the cultivated land by using the modern farming method. The second point is crop season in Palampur. First one is Kharif season and the second one is Rabi season. Kharif season is identified with the rainy season. Crops grown during this season, jowar and bajra, these are used as a cattle feed. Rabi season, it's identified with the winter and dry season. Wheat is an important rabi crop. Sugarcane is used on a large scale. The third point is cropping pattern. Single cropping, double cropping and multiple cropping. In single cropping, one single crop is grown in during the year on a given piece of land, such as sugarcane. Double cropping, two crops are grown during a year on a given piece of land, such as jowar and bajra. And the third one is multiple cropping. There are three or more crops are grown during a year on a given piece of land, for example, jowar, bajra. And the third crop is potato. The fourth point is modern farming methods. It's further divided into two parts. First one is tradition farming method and the second one is modern farming method. Tradition farming method, these include practice which Indian farmers have been using from many generation. Use of pair of bullocks for plogging, drawing water from the well, traditional wooden tool, transportation producing the market through the bullocks cart. Farmer works with the traditional wooden tools and equipment such as old machineries, old seeds, all the things are included. Organic manure provided nutrition to the soil. Because all the things are used without the insecticide and pesticide. So we can say as a result, low productivity of the soil. Because we are using old wooden tool, traditional tools in the traditional farming methods. Now, the second point is modern farming method. This includes use of electricity, machinery and other sources of energy. And irrigation facility, high yield variety of seeds, chemical fertilizers such as pesticide, insecticide, tubules, canals and sources of sources of irrigations, modern implements such as modern machineries, modern tools, all the things are included in modern farming method, which result we can say in modern farming method, the productivity of land increased manifold. Next point is, next part is non-farming activity. Non-farming activity in Palampur. First one is dairy farming. Second one is small-scale manufacturing. Third one is shopkeeping. Fourth one is transportation and third one is self-employed. In dairy farming, people in Palampur are rearing buffaloes. They fed them on different type of grass, jowar and bajra. Milk is sold nearby the village. Some people also set up the collection and the other center from the where the milk is transported to the nearby the village or city. Now we can take the example of dairy products, milk, ghee, curd, etc. The next point is small scale manufacturing. This involves simple product methods are done on a small scale. These are carried out at home with the family members as a laborers. The laborers are rarely hired for these activities. We can take the example of small scale in manufacturing pots and utensils. The next point is shopkeeping. Shopkeeper in Palanpur buy goods from the wholesale market in the cities and sell them into the village. Small stores sell a wide range of products like wheat, rice, oil and some cloth, etc. Some people who have shops near the bus stop use them to sell the eatable also. In shopkeeping, bring the things from the city and sell into the market. And the fourth one is transportation. There are different means of transportation in Palanpur, such as bus, car, truck, rickshaw, tangas, jeep, tractors, etc. These means of transportation are used to transport goods and people from village to city, and the people get paid for this. Self-employed. Some people have opened many centers to obtain the more profits and to train more people for better opportunities in the life. I think computer is the most useful and important for the village because it generates employment for the people being educated. Without a computer education, people are uneducated. It's employed skilled person in the village to teach so that they would not to go other cities and towns in search of employment opportunity. Now we can take the example of self-employed by opening computer training center and stitching center, etc. So these all the activities, all the parts are very important. I hope you are clear with the topic. Thank you.